لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله.
بسم الله أبدأ كلامي وصلاتي وسلامي، المظلل بالغمام، محمد رسول الله.
بسم الله أبدأ كلامي وصلاتي وسلامي، المظلل بالغمام، محمد رسول الله.
اكتب المساجد unfortunately. We have a lot of masajid in the Muslim world, and those masajid actually is beyond even the number. We cannot count how many masajid in the world. And sometimes some people, they think the masjid belongs to them. And even sometimes the people who build the masjid or have a lot of contribution in the masjid, they think they have the upper hand over the masjid. And that is absolutely wrong. But in the masajid is belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Adam alayhi salam to the earth, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam to the earth, bit of sand to create Adam alayhi salam, Jibreel alayhi salam, on that time, he put a spot on this earth to be masajid. He put a spot, an area that would be masajid. So those areas will be built, every single spot Jibreel alayhi salam marked, that will become a masajid. It is with your power, without your power, with your money, without your money, it will become a masjid, the thing will become a masjid, there's no question asked. So does not mean if the person builds the masjid with his own money, that means he owns the masjid, absolutely not. It is from the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why inshaAllah rabbil alameen, tonight we will speak about the masjid. What is the masjid? The main masjid in every place, in next to you, every place, you need to use electrical legends. And the Prophet ﷺ, the earth, Jibal, wa tahura, the earth, the whole earth, is the masjid and clean place to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I think that the Prophet ﷺ, the earth, the earth, أينما أبردتك الصلاة, فصلي. In any place, the power of the salah comes, you must pray. Do not deny the salah. That is your place to make to you, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What masjid from sajad, the word sajad, the three words are between prostration. And when you look your head, your forehead, your nose, your hands, your knees, and your toes on the ground, prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that area is masjid. You can masjid in the house of Allah. You can masjid, you have a masjid inside your own home. Small masjid, there is masjid also. When you study that area, it's for the Salah, we're going to speak about it, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. That is also is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is even inside your house. Even inside your house. So let's go according to أي مسجد وضع في الأرض أولا. Which masjid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been first? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Masjid al-Haram. And why Al-Masjid al-Haram? When Adam alayhi salam came to the earth, Adam alayhi salam, he used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Al-Bayt al-Mahmud, in the heaven, with the angels. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Adam to the earth, Adam alayhi salam, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to build a place to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, build it here under Al-Bayt al-Mahmud. So in the top of the Ka'bah, it is Al-Bayt al-Mahmud in the sama. Where is Adam عليه السلام? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in hadith of Ustaz Ahmad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he showed Adam عليه السلام the shade where exactly the Ka'bah which should be built. And subhanAllah, the foundation of the Ka'bah, different foundation in the whole, for the whole entire area in Makkah al-Mukarram. It's the whole entire foundation. Now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told Ibn Zabir al-Ghaffari radiallahu anhu, قال المسجد الحرام is the first مسجد البيت الحرام. And then قال ثم أي. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال المسجد الأقصى. المسجد الأقصى in Palestine. And أبو ذر الغفاري says قلت كم بينهما. How much time between building المسجد الحرام and المسجد الأقصى. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال 40. One hadith says 40 sana, 40 years, and one hadith is 40, Allah knows that, 40 years or 40 days. But most likely, because when one hadith also comes, 40 years in between both. Adam alayhi salam, he lived more, a little bit less than 1,000 years, 960 years Adam alayhi salam lived. So, قال أينما أدم دين الرب صلى الله عليه وسلم immediately he replied to Abu Dhar قال أينما أدركتك الصلاة فصلي فهو مسجد. And any time the Salah time comes reach, you pray. That is a masjid for you. There's another رواية the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال فكلها مسجد. I mean the whole earth is a masjid. What about water? If you are in a boat, pray. If you are diving, you pray. I have a chance actually to dive once in Salat al-Maghrib. I pray Maghrib under the ocean, alhamdulillah, 65 feet under the ocean, I pray Maghrib. It's the time of the Salah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So that's the halajah. Now let's come to Fadl al-Salah, the virtues of the message. The virtues. Fadl. Oh, my dear brother, my sister. And the hadith in Fadl al-Bina'il. Masajid, that the hadith about the virtues, the benefits of the building masajid is so beautiful in the way you will be so have the courage in every single penny in your pocket just for a thing just to build the masjid or part of the masjid. The first hadith we have here, my dear brothers and my sisters, is hadith Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu qala. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man bana lillahi masjidan yabtaghi bihi wajhi Allah دنا الله له بيتا في الجنة متفق عليه. سيد الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد حديث عثمان رضي الله تعالى عنه whoever builds for Allah سبحانه وتعالى mosque for seeking only Allah سبحانه وتعالى not the name, not his name, not the family name, not a person for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى then Allah سبحانه وتعالى will build for that person a house in the paradise. And they believe me, brothers and sisters, is a big difference between the house in the Jannah and the house on earth. House on earth, every day is breaking something, a plumber or a roof or leaking or this or that. SubhanAllah, but the house of the Jannah, who built the house in the Jannah? Not the angels. Please, not the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself building those houses in the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you see the difference between the brothers and the sisters? So the other hadith we have in the Bible, brothers and sisters, and subhanAllah, that is an invitation, the following hadith, an invitation for even the very poor person. The one very poor is an invitation for him to build the masjid. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال من بنى لله مسجدا ولو كمثل سقطات لبيضها بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال من بنى لله مسجدا whoever built the masjid For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even equal to the nest of birds. How much that nest of birds is so small, you've seen small brick, not even a brick. Not even 10% of the brick almost. With the great brick, not even 1% of the brick. That means a coin. A coin. 25 cents, 5 cents, 10 cents. Any amount of money to build for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build by himself, by his hand, a house in the Jannah, in the paradise. So look at this invitation, subhanAllah, the one thing to think about this, subhanAllah. Also many problems in this world, there is a lot of dua, a lot of ad'iyah, invocation. When you go to the masjid, brothers and sisters, and those ad'iyah, at least one of those du'a, I want just to memorize or two. And any du'a, if you cannot memorize anything, just make du'a, because especially when you are going to the masjid. That means you are going to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah invites you, and guess what? And you're applying, you're accepting the invitation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the beautiful thing, my dear brothers and sisters. List this one of the du'a. Qul bismillah. البروفيسور صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث أم سلمة رضي الله تعالى عنها كان she said كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا خرج إلى المسجد من بيته قال بسم الله توكلت على الله اللهم إني أعوذ بك أن أضل أو أضل أو أذل أو أذل أو أظلم أو أظلم
أو أجهل أو يجهل عليه. رواه أصحاب السنن. ذكر ذي الحديث للسوحاء. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection from everything, even about you. Sometimes we do things, brother and sister, and either you don't mean it, or you don't know how you do it, you just did it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith said, Bismillah, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and every slave, my brother and sister, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا بَارَكَ اللَّهُ بِعَمَلٍ لَمْ يَبْدَ بِهِ. Allah will never bless. Let any work, any action, you don't start by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah, أي بسم الله أبدأ. By the name of Allah, I start. توكلت على الله. توكلت, but my trust depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر كل شيء, من شر protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen, I say, أعوذ بك أن أضل أو أضل. ضلال. Brothers and sisters, what is the dalal exactly? The way in the translation, we see the translation a strain. But if there is a more stronger translation for this, just for a moment, just to think about if in this room, now a lot of light. If I say, brother, can you go to the door and come back? You can go to the door and come back. Easy, because there is a lot of light. And even if I put my brother and sister a glass, or I put like iron bars or something in front of you, because the light, you can then go straight. But if I put like this a glass or nail or something, and then it's completely dark, and say, brother, go to that door, what's going to happen to you? It's impossible to just go safe. There is something going to hurt you. That's what is dalal. You have your eyes. You have your own eyes, but because it's so completely dark, you cannot even go to the door. That's what is dalal. And the dalal, the brothers and sisters, that the one you see the truth, and something blocks your eyes, makes you blind. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Taha, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ ولا يشقى الله اكبر لك فهمت فاما ياتينكم مني when Allah will give you our guidance the Quran the Sunnah the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فاما ياتينكم مني هدى فمن اتبع هداي هو يبصر ما يهدى my guidance my God لا فلا يضل ولا يشقى there is not going to be a strain or misleading the road ومن اعرض عن ذكري فان له معيشة ضنكا and whoever rejects those ayats That means here is dalal. Astray. فَإِنَّنَهُ مَعِيْكَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْنَى He has a miserable life. Miserable life, and we raise him up, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ And the judgment is blind. Blind. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا My Lord, why you raise me up blind? Why I used to have a sight? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى I give you my ayat, I give you my guidance, I give you my Quran and my prophets, and you forgot all those ayat and prophets, and today you will be forgotten. So subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اللهم إني أعوذ بك أن أضل أو أضل. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection, to be astray or to make someone to make him astray. Because you didn't know, you think you are right sometimes and you are astray. And then, أو أذل أو أذل or to make someone to be unjust with him, unfair with him, to be unfair against himself, or to make someone unfair, to cause some unjust to someone. And he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, أو أظلم أو أظلم أو أجهل أو يجهل عليه, to be wrong doors with someone, or do something bad to someone, or someone will do that, something bad to me, to ask Allah for complete protection. For yourself and for the others. For the others too. You don't want to say someone and you don't know. And the other hadith, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, من قال إذا خرج من بيته, if you say, when you exit out of your house, بسم الله توكلت على الله, still, by the name of Allah, you start and the trust depends only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You have no power, no strength without the power and the strength Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. And he said, يقال له حسبك هديت وكفيت ووقيت وتنحى عنه الشيطان. الله أكبر. He said, my dear brothers and sisters, the angel will tell that person, you have guidance, you have a protection, complete protection, and Allah will show you the right way. And the shaitan will run away from the way of that person. When you say this dua again, من قال مقرر whoever exited from out of his house going to the masjid, بسم الله توكلت على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Three statements. The angel will tell you حسبك. That's it. Allah will be sufficient for you. And he said Allah, the angel, هديت وقفيت ووقيت. Yeah? Allah is sufficient for you. That's it. And the shaitan will run away from your side. The coming hadith and dua, you must memorize it. And subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not miss anything. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for nur, for hidayah, for guidance, for everything. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you are leaving the house, going to the masjid. Allahumma ij'al fi qalbi nura. You ask Allah to put light, light in your heart. Allahumma ij'al fi qalbi nura. وفي بصري نورا. In my vision, when I see نور, light. وفي سمعي نورا. In my hearing also light. وعن يميني نورا. In my right. وعن شمعي وخلفي نورا. Behind me. وفي عصبي. Look at this. وفي عصبي. In my nerves. In my nerve system. نور, light. And subhanAllah, the benefit of this nerve is very tiny nerve in the middle of the bones. In the middle of the bone. Today the doctor was showing me that nerve, small, tiny. If that become anything wrong with it, you see, that's what's going to happen. See my neck? That's exactly. Because if the small, tiny nerve system, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, وَفِي لَحْ وَفِي عَصَبِي, in my nerve system, but light. Because that will make it function. Because that's connected to the brain. And he said, وَفِي لَحْمِي نُورَ, your muscle, your flesh, you need light. وَفِي دَمْعِي, يَا اللَّهُ, in my even tears. Because you're blinking, brothers and sisters, with what? If there is no tears, water, inside your eyes, you cannot blink. By the miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this. وَفِي دَمْعِي وَفِي شَعْرِي نُورَ, my hair. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for light. Subhanallah. وفي بشري نورا, all my skin, he needs light. And this another hadith in the Sahih Muslim, اللهم اجعل في قلبي نورا, in my heart, light. وفي لساني نورا, beautiful. In my tongue also with light, to say the truth, to speak the truth, to read the truth, to reject untruth. واجعل في سمعي نورا, in my hearing, وفي بصري, in my vision, ومن خلفي, behind me نورا, ومن أمامي, from me نورا, واجعل من فوق نورا, ومن تحت نورا, اللهم أعطيني نورا. So you ask Allah for نور, light around you, and then اللهم أعطيني. Look at that. Allah give me نور. Something you miss. You ask Allah for نور for that. You must memorize this, my dear brothers and my sisters, inshallah, رب العالمين. There is a lot of dua, he goes to that, but dua, when you enter the masjid, as all of us, you know, you say you masjid, and يَدْخُلَ فَرِجْتِهِ الْمِنَّةِ, you enter with your right foot. You know, ويقول, أعوذ بالله العظيم, وبوجه الكريم, وسلطاني القديم, من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله, اللهم صل على محمد, اللهم اغفر لي ذنوبي, وافتح لي أبواب رحمتك. والدعاء الى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم بسنة enter with your right foot, سأعوذ بالله العظيم وبوجهه الكريم. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the protection by the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the honorable and the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is Kareem? Why is Kareem here? Because when you enter the masjid, you need rahmah. And no one will give you the rahmah, it's a generous one. And the only generous one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First you ask Him by His greatness, praising Allah. And also by His generosity, I need your rahmah. When you enter the masjid, brothers and sisters, say Allah will say, wa yakri, wa sultani al-qadim. Allah creates everything. After this, before Allah, nothing there. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By His power, من الشيطان الرجيم. From the شيطان. From the شيطان. الحمد لله الشيطان لنا مجد. But sometimes we bring the شيطان in the form of a human being. And somebody is going to speak about this. We're going to say sometimes أنا الشيطان انتر the مجد. Not the شيطان instead of sometimes in the form of a human being. Can enter the مجد. Just to make a problem to the people. Can you see? Actually yes. Actually believe me, and we're going to speak about it inshallah. The answer is yes. And they say اللهم صل على محمد. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please Allah the salah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم اغفر لي ذنوبي. You ask Allah before you start your salah to forgive all your sins. وافتح لي أبواب. Look at that. Look at this. وافتح لي أبواب رحمتك. وافتح لي أبواب رحمتك يا الله. You know what that? افتح لي أبواب رحمتك, brothers and sisters. All the gates of mercy. Not only one gate. Gates لا يعلمها إلا الله. No one knows those gates but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knows those gates. No one will know it but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the brothers and sisters, when you exit from the masjid, you pray and you do what we got. Study exactly. You ask Allah say with your left foot, say Bismillah. اللهم صل على محمد. اللهم اغفر لي ذنوبي وافتح لي أبواب فضلك. اللهم اعصمني من الشيطان الرجيم. Look at this again. You ask it in Bismillah. You exit with Bismillah. You enter with Bismillah and you exit with Bismillah. اللهم صل على محمد. Always you praise the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر لي ذنوبي. You just pray. Nothing. You are clean from your sin. They are clean from your sin. But maybe you make some kind of mistake in the salah. You make some thinking sometimes in the salah. You think about unfinished business in the salah. You think about wife, husband, son, daughter, anything. If something happened, make the salah less. You ask Allah for forgiveness for this. You are clean, inshallah. You are clean. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَافْتَحْ لِي أَبْوَابَ فَضْلِكَ. وافتح لي أبواب فضلك يا الله. With this statement, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open all His favors and bounties for you. All the favors and bounties for you. All risk, fadl, risk, sahha, health, money, son, daughter. All these good things, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you still, you ask Allah, ma'asumni min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection from shaytan all the time. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, فضل السعي والجلوس في المسجد. جلوس في المسجد. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, السعي. We go to the masjid. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, من غدا إلى المسجد وراح أعد الله له الجنة نزلا. كلما غدا أو راح. Look at this hadith. That's big. Make us more attached to the masjid. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, من غدا إلى المسجد وراح. Ever come to the masjid and leave the masjid. غدا أو راح. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every single time you go to the masjid, come back from the masjid, Allah will build the house for you in the Jannah. Nuzula. Nuzula, you know what nuzula, my dear brothers and sisters? it's not a house. I was wrong. You know what the nuzula is? You know, five stars hotel, how much is so beautiful, the five stars hotel, the mess. There are some hotels in one night, around $20,000. Literally, I'm not joking. $20,000 hotel. I don't know what is in the hotel yet. I don't know yet. But Allah says, when this young man is definitely saying there is anything you wish, it is there. That's what it nizzle. Nizzle, the hotel itself in Arabic language, call it nizzle. The hotel call it nizzle. And when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nizzle, it's Allah. You don't ask Allah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every time you come to the masjid and leave, there is a nizzle, there is a special place, not five stars, five stars of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a different star there. A real star. Allah will prepare it for you in the Jannah. InshaAllah. That's an invitation, brothers and sisters. That's a beautiful invitation. And even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الرَّجُلِ يَعْتَتَ الْمَسْجِدِ. If you see the man, always come to the masjid, فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. Ya Allah. If you see the masjid, the man going to the masjid, come back from masjid, you will witness that that person is a mu'min. That person is a believer. Immediately, my brothers and my sisters. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says also, in many hadith, I'm not going to read all the hadith with that, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا أَدَلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَا يَمْحُ اللَّهُ بِالْخَطَاوَى الْخَطَايَى وَيَرْفَعُ بِهِ الدَّرَجَاتِ. Say, should I tell you what is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is make Allah will erase all your sin and raising your level in the Jannah. And that's when you go to the masjid more often. When you go to the masjid more often. I'll speak now for virtues, the excellence of the masajid. I'm not going to stay much with this because I want to speak about the etiquette and manners of the masajid, inshallah. And the first hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansar. Equivalent to 100,000 salah. To pray in Mecca, equivalent to 100,000 times rak'ah. To pray in Masjid Nabawi, it is 1,000 salah, and to pray in Masjid Al-Aqsa. So it does not mean when you go pray 500 salah, that's equivalent to Masjid Al-Aqsa. No, that is the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives special. And especially when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا تشد الرحال إلا إلى ثلاث. To travel for a masajid only for three masajid. That is Masjid Al-Haram, then Mecca Mukarram, Masjid Al-Madina, and Masjid Al-Aqsa. And Masjid Al-Aqsa. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited to make the decoration in the Masjid. Subhanallah, some Masjid is beautiful, gorgeous. Beautiful and gorgeous. If you tell me, it's a picture. Seriously. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تقوم الساعة. Please give me attention to this hadith. And you see that. Since Al-Asr al-Fatih, until Al-Asr actually Al-Amawi, until today, you see this kind of bid'ah. Say, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتباهى الناس في المساجد. One of the time of the day of judgment, when the people build a beautiful, beautiful masjid, decoration, cost millions of dollars, that is one of the signs of the day of judgment. سيأتي على أن Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال نظر حديث ابن خزيمة قال يأتي على الناس زمان يتباهون بالمساجد ثم لا يعمرونها إلا قليلا. They will time come upon my ummah. The people will be very proud of their masajid. Oh, I saw this masjid and very proud. And there is no one go to this masjid maybe Friday only. Maybe Friday only. And this is happening here in America. In America, so one of the masjid, he cost the people $15 million. I'm not going to mention names, we are alive. $15 million. Unfortunately, they pay only Jum'ah. Only Jum'ah in this masjid. Subhanallah, always the truth. Always the truth. Unfortunately, of course. Unfortunately. The hadith Prophet Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Amr ibn al-Masajid. Umar رضي الله عنه كان خليفة أمير المؤمنين. He ordered the people to build masajid all over, and he said, أكن الناس من المطر وإياك أن تحمر أو تسطر فتسط الناس. That's Umar saying. Umar saying, he ordered the people to build masajid, and he said, but do not just to protect the people from the rain. Protect the people from the rain. Now alhamdulillah we have air condition, Allah, it is fine too. But he said, do not make colors, make all kind of colors, ahmar and asfar, red and yellow and this and that. That is a fitna for the people. Fitna for the people. So a lot of people are going to enter the masjid, you'll find this thing, ayat all over. Beautiful ayat. And I challenge if someone can read this ayat. I challenge if someone can even comprehend what is this ayat. It's some kind of hieroglyphic language. And that is not the sign, that's one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, brothers and sisters. To look there, I was not there in the building. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hadith ibn Abbas, and one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, لَتُسَخْرِفُونَهَا كَمَا زَخْرَفَتَ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى. That's it. their prophecy. You will do it. You will make it depression and fantasy stuff and fantasy things. And just like the Jews and the Christians, it will happen, and it's happening now. There are some messages I visited in Cairo. You'll be amazed how this is happening. Amazed. It's so beautiful in the way. And even in the Muslim country, how many people just want to pray? And now the minbar is supposed to be free. I saw in one line when I was in college in Egypt, so one imam, he was going to the minbar, and the minbar exactly 30 steps, not 3. Not 3, 30, 30 steps. After 15 steps exactly, the imam died with heart attack. With heart attack. Supposed to be 3, not 30. And go climb, he cannot climb, yahi. That's it. They want to be left on. Alright. Okay, and also the sunnah, maybe brothers and sisters, clean up the masjid. And the perfume, the hadith that says, say, كنا كان يأمرنا بالمساجد أن نصنعها في دورنا ونصف أن نصنعها في دورنا. A prophet he used to order us to have a musalla, masjid, small masjid in your house. When you have a new house, may Allah grant all of you, have a small area, this is for the salah. Teach your son, your daughter, your wife, yourself, this is for ibadah, this is for a place. It's a sunnah to have this kind of place inside the house, inshallah. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was saying that كان Abdullah ibn Abdullah, he used to bring incense and perfume in the day of the Jum'ah, about in the masjid for the people to smell. For the people to say, this is sunnah to make the masjid, it's so beautiful, but not all of you. Come, it become disaster. You have to make arrangements with the imam, something. In case, you know, that's like some kind of perfume, you come like 1 hour early, 2 hours early, and you start it. Because some people have an asthma, and they cannot have it. So it's just like 2-3 hours before to make it clean and some and help. With that, inshallah, Rabbi, that is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this beautiful hadith. Beautiful hadith. قَلْ عُرِضَتْ عَلَيَّ أُجُورُ أُمَّتِي. I saw the rewards, the hasanat, the good deeds for my ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I saw, عُرِضَتْ. It represents, displayed for me, the ujur, the reward of my ummah. And he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حتى القدر يخرج الرجل منه. Even small dirt, the man will take it out of the masjid, clean the masjid. And I told you once in the hadith in the morning, in خطبة الجمعة, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he met a woman, she used to clean the masjid, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when she died, he was asleep.
لا إله إلا الله, لا إله إلا الله, لا إله إلا الله. محمد رسول الله
صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. محمد رسول الله.
وصلاة وسلام. المبلغ بالغمام
رسول الله. Is garlic or onion? Why does it smell? And for the cigarette. The cigarette is more than even the garlic and onion. More than the garlic and onion, the cigarette. So the person who has small smoke, you have to make the Prophet, he said about the garlic and onion, and let you cook it with the cooking. That's fine, that smell will go away. So the person with the smoke should not come to the masjid unless if he eats something before he comes, because that is bothering the people next to him. The people will eat anything. Make the smell, like the curry. Sometimes the curry is stuck in the clothes. We have to make sure there is a perfume, a special perfume, and a special deodorant for the man when he comes to the masjid to smell good. It's an obligation, brothers and sisters. It's not a joke. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person should not sell or buy, prohibited for an ounce of even the loss. If the person lost pass something in the masjid, outside, come to the masjid and say, oh, I lost things, I lost it. Anybody can find me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you said, make dua till you will never find your thing. Until you find something, give it to the imam, and the imam take care of it. But to make the announcement, this is not the masjid, it's for ibadah. You should not sell and buy in the masjid. That is for ibadah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, unless there is a fundraising for the masjid. Selling and buying is for the purpose of the masjid. That is, excuse me, you know, it's not for profit. It's for raising money to maintain the masjid. It's completely different story. But for personal interest, this is the masjid is not for you. It's not for you. this is number 13 here, brothers and sisters, one of the important things, and please give attention. I will read and translate and explain, inshallah. رفع الصوت في المسجد. To have a loud voice in the masjid, scream in the masjid, fight people sometimes, fight in the masjid. That is haram. Literally, it's haram to speak aloud and scream and yell and curse sometimes inside the masjid. If somebody curse you, you take it. That will be cursed. That will be cursed. You brothers and my sisters. It's very important, raising your voice in the mosque, in the masjid, that is one of the great sins. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, قال هذه من الكبائر. كبائر, that's one of the great sins. Even if you are one of those people who donate thousands of millions of dollars in the masjid, still you have no right to do so. With respect and honor, because the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and even if you raise your voice reading Quran, reading Quran, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in his room, and somebody read the Quran, and he said, lower your voice. Lower your voice. Because someone else read the Quran, he disturbed him, or maybe somebody praying, and you cannot comprehend. That is very important, brothers and sisters. Okay. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْمُصَلِّي يُنَاجِي رَبَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فَلْيَنْظُرْ بِمَا يُنَاجِيهِ. Okay. وَلَا يَجْرَ بَعْضُكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ بِالْقُرْآنِ. So no one recites the Qur'an, and the other person recites the Qur'an, and the other person maybe somebody speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He disturbs that person. He disturbs that person. It's really important, brothers and sisters. We have to be careful with this. Some people, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, the imam speak. The imam, it happened to me personally. I was making khutbah, and somebody just stood up and said, you are kafir. You are kafir. Whoa. In the middle of everybody. After he stood and said, I say, you finished? I say, yeah. And I say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. I'm a Muslim now. Let's continue. So it's really important, brothers and sisters. You should not accuse anybody. You should not raise your voice. If you don't like something from the Imam, you take the Imam outside and speak with him. It is one of the really great fitnah. And I really want to emphasize this thing. It's a great fitnah if you find something you don't like from the Imam, and immediately on the spot, you correct the Imam in front of everybody. Who are you to do this? Just because you one of the members in daily members in the masjid is not right. Even though. Even if he is your friend, if the Imam your best friend, you should not do that as well. Even though. But if the Imam does something, in aqeedah matter, in aqeedah matter, then you can correct it if you have the knowledge, not the personal opinion. In one Salat al-Janazah once, the Imam wants to start and he starts to explain, and subhanAllah, from every place, people start to correct the Imam. The Imam speaker is absolutely correct, but people with their custom and tradition, he said, no Fatiha. No, you have to read Fatiha. And they start to be able to fight on the janazah. I wish in that day to have a wali, a Muslim leader, to take those people, and what they do, cut their tongues. They should cut their tongues, would never speak forever. And that is the best solution for those people. They are always raising their voices and screaming inside the masjid. Screaming about the masjid and correcting the imam and speaking this because of personal interest. or opinion, and sometimes the imam have a different madhab or school of thought, and you have the people have different school of thought, start to correct it and start to speak. That is disaster. And this, I'm telling you, brother, this is happening. Not for you, because other people listening to us now, and it's a message for everyone, inshallah. All right. Also, to speak with something, you can speak in Prophet, كانوا يتحدثون فيحضرون في أمر جارية فيضحكون ويبتسمي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Sahaba, رضوان الله عنهم, they used to sit in the masjid, and they remember something in the past, like some jokes from Jahiliyyah, the pre-Islam. And then they're making jokes, and the Prophet smiles. He never prevent that, as far as it's not a haram. Or, and another hadith is not mentioned in the book, the Sahaba, they used to talk to the watermelon. Eat watermelon and the rest they start to throw it against you. And the Prophet said, oh, but then do this in the masjid. But this carpet, there is a gravel and sand. It's become a problem. But as far as it's nothing haram, it's not a problem. It's not a problem. And you can eat and drink in the masjid. And see in the masjid that Ahl al-Sunnah, the brothers and the sisters, you can eat and you can drink and this, but also you have to make sure, you should make sure the masjid is clean after. The masjid is clean after you eat, you drink, you sleep, and some people come traveling from distance and they sleep in the masjid and they leave everything there. And some people, they come to the masjid. And wallahi, this is happening, brothers and sisters. And then they cook inside the masjid. And what they cook? Curry, onions. And Prophet doesn't eat it, and you cook it in the masjid. How dare you do something like this? How dare, really, you do something like this? Oh, we are travelers. Yeah, go outside and cook. Why inside the masjid with this kind of smell? Some masjid, you enter, you're in the kitchen. Should not. You should not. You don't accept this in your house. You better than not accepting this in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Simple, my dear brothers and sisters. Yes. Also, you enter that during when you wait into Salah, to speak in Allah. What is that called in English? You put your fingers crossing each other like this. But during that, when you wait for Salah, this is especially when you are waiting for the Salah, not all the time. When you are waiting for the Salah. Some ulama, this is known all the time. But the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says clearly, in the hadith it says, during the Salah. فَإِنَّهُ فِيْفَرْ You are waiting for the Salah. You are waiting, that means the adhan, and you are waiting for the iqama. In between, it's fine. During the Salah, when you are waiting for Salah, it's bad. That is fine, yeah. This is fine. This is okay. But you do like this. You're crossing your fingers, crossing each other, that like just like this. But that is when you are waiting for the Salah. No. Waiting. You're not waiting for Salah. We just pray Isha. So we now in this moment you finish the Salah. It's fine. But when you are waiting between the Adhan and the Iqama, that is the Hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم another Hadith and he said, "Finish the kind of in the speak in the Shaitan." It's from the shaitan. And he saw one guy, he's doing this, and he took his hand. And he told him, don't cross your fingers together, but this is from the shaitan as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, brothers and sisters, when you pray, some certain pray, they pray all the time. You should change. You should not pray in a certain place, because every place is a witness for you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Some people, that is a bid'ah. Some people pray here, and they change, and they change, and they change, and they crossing. That is, you pray in that spot, and that's it, alhamdulillah. But you change all the time, the Sahaba never done it, the Sahaba never done it, the Prophet never done it, we should not do it. Alright, okay, because the time is running, we must pray to Sutra. Yes? الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى الإمام الحنيف رحمه الله تعالى if you're not afraid if somebody will cross in front of you pray anywhere you want but the hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم please give your attention he never prayed he never made his salah the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم without sutra what is the meaning of this and he always صلى الله عليه وسلم said pray to sutra what is the sutra the size of the sutra where is the spear Or arrow. The arrow normally, just like your arm. Your army, how many inches? How many feet? 2.5 feet? 2.5 feet, 2 feet, something. But of course, we don't have a spear now. We don't have arrow now. Pray next to the wall, pray to the, pray to next to someone. If one of the brothers sitting, pray behind him. It's fine. If that's, it's not crossing in front of you. If that's it. But you must pray to sutra. A lot of people, they just like, take it easy. They, you pray in the middle of the masjid. So yes, there is. Some of madahib or school of thought, if you're not afraid somebody will pass, but the Prophet ﷺ, when he's in the desert, who's going to pass from the, in the desert? No one will pass. But it's still, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is sutra. What is the sutra? Will you have something in front of you like a divider? Where is, at the side of the sutra is your, where did you put your head? Forehead, where you put your forehead on the floor on the ground? That almost touching that area, that the sutra, the place, the divider, that thing. Or just like column or something like this. Something you put in front of you. The wall of the masjid, chair. That is the sutra. Yeah, but we must take this serious, and a lot of people is not taking this serious. I didn't know why, and always we speak about that still. But in the long jama'ah, the sutra of the imam is your sutra. The sutra of your, the imam is your sutra. It's fine. Even if there's somebody in front of you, passing in front of you, this is fine, it's not a problem with that at all. Alright? But if you pray by yourself, you always, even if you are praying inside the house, if you're inside your home, even though you take your sutra, and you have to be very close to the sutra. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if somebody is, you know, you're praying and somebody, you have your sutra here, that means you have your excuse, and somebody want to cross between you and the sutra, you push him. You push that person, and he insists to come. You push him again. The third time, what you do? Hit him. Of course, in America, they're going to sue you. If you are sure he's not going to sue you, just hit him. Otherwise, just stop him somewhere, somehow. I don't want to say how, but stop him. And because if he insists, the Prophet says, sorry, insists, he's a shaitan. You read on Yaqta alayka salah, he wants to cross to cut your salah. So, I didn't know what kind of people get really insisting to do something like this. Alright, inshallah. That's all I want to say about my the salah, my brother. This is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the place of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the house in the Jannah, in the paradise, with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima, wa qalban khashi'a, wa yaqeenan sadiqa, wa ilman nafi'a.